So real quick, I want to show this play. This was just a play I discovered when I was watching film of Fitzpatrick. Not really relevant to the video too much, but just if you're someone who's a Washington football team fan and haven't followed Fitzpatrick too much, you're going to love this play, and this is exactly why you're going to love Fitzpatrick. It's just simply a handoff. So you would think it has nothing to do with Fitzpatrick, right? And watch, he does hand the ball off, but then look at him hustle downfield and give a lead block for his halfback. I mean, come on. You got to love that if you're a fan of football, and that's exactly why everyone seemingly loves Ryan Fitzpatrick. Just stuff like that. All right, so that was fun, but now let's get into what this video is actually going to be talking about. And I think a lot of people sort of wonder, well, why does Ryan Fitzpatrick seemingly have such a, you know, Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde type of, feel to him, right? Why does it seemingly his best games he throws for 400 yards and his worst games he throws for 4 interceptions? Why does he have such a disparity that most guys don't have? Maybe like a Jameis Winston as well, but it's very rare. And there's a reason for it. It's not just luck. It's not just that he happens to be an inconsistent player. There's a legitimate, like, X's and O's reason why you see such a disparity in his best games and his worst games. So that's what I wanted to talk about in today's video. So we'll start off with this play, and this is going to be a completely inconsequential play. I'll tell you right now, it's going to be a missed throw, a little bit too high. It has nothing to do with anything. So why am I bringing it up? Well, again, there is a legitimate reason for it, and this is actually a great example of showing kind of how Fitzpatrick plays. So this is going to be a man coverage play, but it's a unique coverage for New England. They have three players back. It's not cover three because two are kind of in a buzz concept, but you then have a safety who's deep as well. So again, New England, they'll throw stuff at you that other teams won't. It's only a three-man rush, but the route that Fitzpatrick kind of wants to throw to is going to go over in the middle. But of course, with the extra traffic that New England has there, it's going to be more difficult than, say, if this was just like a cover one blitz, for example. And like, watch, right when this play starts, you notice Fitzpatrick, he's completely just looking over the middle of the field. That's where he's looking. And again, all of this, fine, sure, nothing special up until this point. But what really I'm going to want you to look at is how quickly he goes from looking over the middle of the field to throwing completely away from the middle of the field. I mean, watch him just at an instant say, okay, I'm throwing it over there then, and it doesn't work because, you know, it was a little bit too high, and maybe he thought the route was going a bit further, I don't know. But that's just kind of an interesting sort of example of how Fitzpatrick plays as a player, and this results in some very good stuff and some very bad stuff. So, like right here, I mean, the bad stuff is obvious, right? No one's confused, well, how could this turn into a bad scenario? No, we all understand how this could be bad if things don't go well. So, like on this play, it's a little bit off screen right now, but it's Parker going up one-on-one against Gilmore. That's what the route is. This is man coverage, and you see the route on your screen. Fitzpatrick takes the snap here, and he is going to go look in that direction. And at this point, Parker is getting ready to get open. It looks like this could be a good throw to make. We don't know if it's going to be a good throw to make, but it looks like it could be. And again, this is exactly who Fitzpatrick is as a player. This is why you will have some Fitzmagic, and it's why you'll have some Fitztragic, because he's going to make this throw now. I mean, he's about to start the throwing motion as I'm speaking right now, which means he's making his decision to throw it right now when it's impossible to sit here and say for sure that this is going to be open. And also, quick apologies. I said it was Parker. It is not. It is Preston Williams, number 18, not 11. But again, that's not really relevant right here. Although maybe you could argue it is because, you know, Fitzpatrick has this confidence to try Preston Williams in this situation when he's going up against Stephon Gilmore, because he'll make this throw. And as you see, Williams is going to kind of slip a little bit, which allows Gilmore to get the interception. So again, it's not like this was a horrible decision by any means, but basically the whole point is that, you know, when Fitzpatrick talked about with Tua, of you got to sometimes make some decisions where you're throwing it to a guy who's NFL open as opposed to college open. Well, this is NFL open, which is a guy who isn't even open yet, but you want to time it right. Some quarterbacks will not do this. Some quarterbacks will only throw it if they see a guy open. But Fitzpatrick, he's willing to take that chance. And while it does come back to bite him sometimes, there's the flip side. There is something like this where what's going to happen on this play is that this is in the Jacksonville game. And quite frankly, Fitzpatrick's the kind of guy where if you give him good receivers, he's going to have a lot of fun. It's part of why him and Parker have had such a good combination and such a good, you know, the time they had together was very good because Parker's a really good jump ball receiver. And you also saw this when Fitzpatrick went off with Tampa Bay, when he had DeSean Jackson and Mike Evans and a young Chris Godwin and O.J. Howard and all of those guys. But like, watch. So this is man coverage. It's a player running over the middle, Devontae Parker, and watch what's going to happen. So again, right when this play starts, you see Fitzpatrick take the snap. And, you know, there's the inside leverage right here. This is a good decision to make. But it's also, you know, you could argue it's a risky one. Like, there are guys who won't want to make this chance because it could result in an interception, you know? Like, for example, I don't know if Alex Smith makes this throw. That's not to say that one is better than the other. It's just a compare and contrasting of styles. Fitzpatrick is going to make this throw, and they get a big completion right there. So, again, there's good and bad. This is what results in Fitz magic. This is what results in Fitz tragic. It's not, you know, two different things. It's not inconsistency. It literally is two sides of the same coin. I find it very interesting, you know, just the difference in styles that some guys have, right? It's not really to say that one is better than the other, but I would actually say that if you are someone who has the skill set of Fitzpatrick, who's, you know, pretty accurate and has a pretty good arm. Like, his arm talent, I think, sometimes will surprise me at how good his arm talent is. You might as well, but, you know, maybe you're not elite. You're not Aaron Rodgers, let's say. So instead of trying to sort of out Tom Brady guys, well, instead, sometimes you got to just find a way to have success on the NFL field. And Fitzpatrick is a guy who can do that. So I think he's a pretty good player. And I think that this style really has clearly worked for him. I mean, you know, you think about like that crazy play with Miami against the Raiders where he was able to, you know, find a honey hole in the cover two while his, you know, head was getting pulled off seemingly. But at the same time, it's almost like, well, sure, of course he can make that throw. He makes throws while barely looking at guys all the time. I mean, this is just what he does, is he's quick to make a throw. And, you know, it kind of all comes back to that first play I showed you of he's just all heart. He's just going to go for it. He's going to figure something out. And maybe it won't work out. And maybe it'll blow up in his face. But he's going to take the chance. And he's a guy who I feel like I would love to play for if I was a wide receiver. Because at least the ball is going to come my way. Maybe I won't be able to catch it. Maybe it won't be a great situation. Maybe it won't be a good decision from him. But at least I'm going to get an opportunity. So, again, from the actual X's and O's standpoint, there probably are some throws he shouldn't make. But at the same time, the fact that he takes those chances, you know, a lot of times it's the 9 out of 10, this works. The 1 out of 10, everyone's going to make fun of me for it. But I'll take the 9 out of 10 and win a good amount of football games doing it. So, yeah, it's interesting to watch. But that's what he's going to bring to Washington. Should be fun. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. And, of course, as always, thanks for watching.